Okay, plasmid transformation is a process of essentially cutting and pasting genes from one organism to another to create new gene combinations or to create this recombinant DNA. The cutting and the binding or the pasting are done with enzymes. The enzymes that are responsible for the cutting, and cutting is breaking bonds. Sometimes instead of the word cutting or breaking bonds, you might also hear it being referred to as digesting. The restriction enzymes are specific, just like the enzymes of your digestive system, and the locations where they will cut or break these bonds, separate these base pairs of a gene, they're called restriction sites. Now, what you're looking at here is, okay, sorry, that was Caesar Flickerman having a fit. But anyways, so what we have here is we have a piece of DNA. I can tell it's DNA because there's two strands and there are T's and not U's. So what we have here, it says, I can't read it with my glasses, BAMHI. So the names of these enzymes are like HEN3, this BAMHI. So they've got funny names, but where it's going to cut is going to be a specific place just to this BAMHI. And you could see where it's cut here. We see that it has left a little bit of a hangover. Do you see that? It goes ACG. And then the G is over there. So it cut between the two G's and has left a little bit of a hangover. So there's a C, T, A, or G, and on the other end is a G, A, T, or C. These are the sticky ends. So these sticky ends doesn't mean they're gooey. What it means is that they can be easily recombined with another piece of DNA from another organism. And you can imagine that. You could see that happen. You could see putting these two pieces back together. But this is essentially what you need to happen is using an enzyme, cutting at the restriction sites, and then rejoining these pieces with DNA from another organism. And where they're going to be rejoined, they're going to be joined into the plasmid, the single circular piece of DNA. And the enzyme for that is a DNA ligase. So, looking at this picture here, we can see the plasmids, these single circular pieces of DNA. So over here is the bacterial DNA. So that's has the A's and T's and C's and G's that are used to control this bacteria and make its proteins and all of that stuff. The plasmid is what's going to be used to transfer the DNA that has been recombined into the target organism. So we can see it here going back to that human insulin being produced in another organism. The vehicle, the vector of moving these genes from human is going to be the bacteria using that plasmid, that single circular piece of DNA. So we can see in the second picture there, the plasmid itself has been cut with restriction enzymes and it has sticky ends and it will join with the sticky ends of the gene for the production of human insulin. And then this will be used inside of the target organism. So usually like in the pancreas of not the human making the human insulin, but a hamster, not a hamster, goodness, a cow or a pig. So usually you hear something like it being used in a bovine. Now, Bacterial transformation has been around for a long time, the discovery of bacterial transformation, that is. So I'm going to stop here and let you watch this video. So this video is about Frederick Griffith, who's known as the pneumonia man, who was he was a physician. He was trying to find a vaccine for pneumonia, and what he found was not a vaccine for pneumonia, but he found about bacteria. He found out about bacterial transformation. So I'll meet you on the other side of the Frederick Griffith video and a bunch of dead mice.